Former General Nathan Bedford Forrest of the Confederate cavalry nodded to the comrade who refilled his coffee mug. So he wouldn't swallow his thick mustache as he sipped, Bedford inserted the hair into the mug's specially built inside pocket.
"Wonderful," he said a moment later. "Simply wonderful."
The other former general, a heavily bearded man named Jack Gordon, replied,
"It's good coffee, but I wouldn't go that far."
Alice's nervous titter came out too high-pitched. Gordon gave her an odd look.
"I meant this," Bedford said, gesturing to the church. "The depth of Colonel Norwick's ingenuity rivals that of his societal dedication."
"Huh?"
Gordon raised an eyebrow, a magnificent effect over the battle scar on his left cheek.
"Do I apprehend a poet emerging from the forest?"
The men's laughter made her cringe.
"And what say you, Mrs. Norwick?" Gordon said.
"You don't want to know what I think," she thought, but pretended to be enraptured with the sight of the widow Libby Hughes's 2-foot-tall cross centered on the altar table. Although now adorned with orange blossoms, it was still a knife that Thorne had driven into her, an affront. "My husband has indeed committed a dramatic act,"